friends, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So, as we know in our biology, we are discussing our lesson that is reaching the age of adolescence. Okay, so today we have reached the last point of the lesson. Today we will discuss the last point from the lesson, and the point is what? Role of hormones in completing the life history of insects and frog. Okay. So, what we are going to see in this particular point? So, like that up till now we have discussed that in the human body so many changes takes place, that all the changes are takes place with the help of the certain hormones which are secreted by the different endocrine glands. Okay. Similarly, like human being, there are certain hormones are there which are necessary for the proper growth of the insects and frogs, or in the certain organisms where the hormones are very important for their proper growth. So, my dear students, in your previous class in the standard 7, you have discussed about, or we have learned about, the life cycle of silkworm. Okay. So, in this way, like that, silkworms are showing the metamorphosis. In this way, the frog is also showing the metamorphosis. Now, what is meant by the metamorphosis? Metamorphosis means what? The change of the larva into the adult frog with the drastic changes, okay? And that type of the changes, or it is called as what? Metamorphosis means the larva doesn't look similar to the frog. The initial stage or the adult stage, both the stage looks different from each other, and that process we can call as what? Metamorphosis. The frog is also showing the metamorphosis, okay? But to convert that larva into an adult frog, they are going through the different stages, and to get convert that larva or that tadpole, we can say that, that tadpole into the adult frog, that tadpole requires the proper amount of the, enough amount of the thyroxine hormone, which is secreted by the thyroid, which is produced by thyroid, okay, which is produced by thyroid. So, what we have discussed, that larva or the tadpole also requires the proper amount of the thyroxine hormone, which are produced by the thyroid for their proper growth to get convert into an adult frog. Okay. So, if there is a necessary of the thyroxine hormone to secrete the thyroxine hormone, that water should require the enough amount of the iodine. So, if the water contains the enough amount of the iodine, then this thyroid can produce this thyroxine hormone, which is helpful for the proper growth of the tadpole. Okay. So, if there is a not enough amount of the iodine, then there will be not enough amount of the thyroxine also, which will affect the growth of the tadpole, okay, or which will stunted the growth of the tadpole. Okay. So, in this way, what we have discussed, that thyroxine hormone also controls the growth of the frog or the growth of the tadpole. Okay. Now we'll move for the next one point, that is what? Reproductive health. Okay, reproductive health. So if we talk about the health, health is not just the physically active. Okay. Health means what? The everyone or the person, if we talk about the health, the person, his or her social well-being, or what? Physical, social and the mental well-being means only you can call it as what? Health. If the person is what? Physically healthy, socially and the mentally healthy, then we can call it as that a person is what? Healthy. Okay. So, we can say also that health is a physical and a mental well-being. If the person is a physically and mentally, both are active, both are fit, then the person is what? Physically active or the healthy, we can tell that. Next one, here we are going to discuss about the reproductive health. So, once the adolescence period starts, then that adolescent should take the proper care. They should be physically active, they should be socially or the mentally active, okay. They should take the proper diet, they should take the balanced diet, they should take care of their body, there should be the proper personal hygiene, there should be proper adequate physical exercise, okay. So all these things the adolescents have to do to keep them physically healthy or to maintain their proper reproductive health, okay. Next, let's move to the next point, that nutritional needs of adolescents, okay. So now adolescents means what? The person, those who are having the rapid changes or the growth is more in this adolescence period, okay. So as we know, in that period the person or that adolescents require the enough amount of the food or the balanced diet. Now, what is meant by the diet? When you say the diet which contains all the components. Now, which are the food components? As we know, carbohydrates, protein, fats, vitamins, and minerals. So, the diet which contains all the food components in a proper amount, along with that food component, the diet which requires the enough amount of the water and roughage, then that diet is called as what? Balanced diet. So, the adolescent should take the proper amount of the balanced diet. They can include the more protein-rich food into their meal, into their daily meal. Also, they can have the different types of the leafy vegetables, fruits to keep their body healthy and also to fight against the different diseases. Okay. So, in this way, they should contain or they should include all these different food components and all these different types of the food in their daily meal. Along with that, the next one point we discuss, that is what? Personal hygiene. It is very important. So, during the adolescence period, there are so many changes takes place in the body. And during that period, it is very important to take some personal hygiene. Okay. So, one should do the bath every day. Why it is important? Because during the teenagers or during this adolescence period, your body started to perspire more. Your body releases the more amount of the sweat, and which is having the particular type of the odor. Okay, so to avoid that, the one should take the bath every day, or you can take the bath twice a day also. In case of the girls, whenever they are having the menstrual cycles, they should take the proper care. They should take the proper bath whenever it is required, and they should take care of their body. So, if there will be no personal hygiene, then what will happen? Then there are the chances of certain bacterial infections. Okay. So, that is the reason that teenagers or adolescents should take the proper hygiene, or they should take care of their body properly. They should maintain cleanliness of their body. Next, we will discuss about the physical exercise. So, along with all these things, if you want to keep your body healthy, then you should do the enough or the adequate amount of the physical exercise, okay, which helps to improve our blood circulation, helps to take the more amount of the oxygen in our body, and helps to keep our body fit and healthy. Okay, so this is all about today. All these things we have to do to maintain our reproductive health. Now we will discuss about saying no to drugs. Now, what is it by saying no to drugs? Because up till now we have seen that different puberty changes are there. Okay, or during the puberty, so many changes takes place in our body. Okay, so it is natural process. This is the natural process in the growing. While we are growing, all these things will take place, and all the things are natural. So no need to take worry about it. No need to feel some insecurities. No need to feel any insecure feeling about all these changes. Okay, so if someone will prescribe you any types of the drug, you take this drug, then you will feel better, then say no. Okay, only until and unless that drug is prescribed by the doctor. Okay, because once you will take that drug and if you feel the better, then you will add it to that particular disease. You will take it again and again, and at the end, what will happen? You becomes the addict for that certain drugs. Okay, so you should say no to the drugs. Also, as we know, we are having the different types of the diseases. Some are getting spread through the bacteria, viruses. Okay, so just now we are suffering from the one of the diseases, that is what? COVID-19. But before some years ago, there was a very well known disease. Now it is also present, that is what? AIDS. What is meant by the AIDS? Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, which is caused by one of the virus, that is what? HIV. Human immunodeficiency virus. Okay, so this is the disease which is causes due to the virus, and there are the certain possibilities. Because of that possibilities, only this disease will get spread from the infected person to the healthy person. One of the possibilities or one of the chances to transmit the disease is what? If the same needle, okay, or if the needle will get passed from the infected person to the healthy person, then the disease will get spread. If the infected blood comes in the contact of the healthy person, then also it will get infected. Also, this disease will get spread from the infected mother to the offspring. And also, if once we keep in the sexual contact with the infected person, then that person will also get the same disease. Okay, so all these are the certain possibilities with the help of that these diseases are getting spread. Okay, so here we are talking about what AIDS. Also, there are the certain myths, taboos, and what do and don'ts. Okay, so what does mean all these things? So all these things, myths means what? These are the things present, and the people are believes on that, but their things are totally wrong. They are not having any logical reason. Okay, so we should discard all the things from the society. One of the myths we can say that if the girl is having the menstruation and if she will look towards the boy, then she will get a pregnant. So that is a totally myth, because we have seen that how the pregnancy takes place. Okay, next one is that during the menstruation it is not allowed to the girls to do the work in the kitchen. That is also the misbelief, that is also not having any logical reason. And also very important is that for the girl's child or for the birth of the girl child, there is a responsibility, the mother is totally responsible for that. Okay, that is also not true at all. You can see the thing logically or the scientifically. Okay, so this is all about today. We have discussed about the last point from the lesson. So here we have completed our this lesson. Here we will stop. We'll meet in the next video with the next concept. So here is the time to tell you goodbye and for today. Thank you.